Hi guys, Syed Balki here from WP Beginner, and in this video I'll be showing you how to create a lightbox pop-up in WordPress to grow your email list. I used this exact same technique that took less than 10 minutes and grew my email subscribers by 600%. I went from getting around 70 to 80 new subscribers a day to getting 445 to 470 new subscribers. Yes, and this was done with the same amount of traffic, I was just losing subscribers. Before I go further, I want to talk about how I hate pop-ups. Most pop-ups are really, really annoying. You know, one of those open behind the window with music, super annoying. Then there's other ones that you see other bloggers using that opens right when you end up on their website or after 5 seconds on their website. Those are kind of distracting because you're reading through a site and, you know, you're prompted with this message that distracts you. So I'm going to talk about a plugin called OptinMonster that creates smart lightbox pop-ups. And the reason why this is a smart pop-up is it doesn't show when the user is browsing your website. It shows right when the user is about to exit. So we ran a split test on WP Beginner to see how Lightbox pop-up, you know, affects our bounce rate or whether we get any user complaints. The first thing was that we didn't get any user complaints. Second, our bounce rate stayed the exact same. Now, it makes sense, right? Because the user that was going to leave was going to leave anyways. Now, a lot of the times, you know, your website visitors would like the content that they read, but they don't subscribe. Why? Because they have a short attention span, and most websites don't have a clear call to action. So right when they're leaving, if you prompt them with a gentle message saying, hey, would you like to hear more from me, or here's a free ebook that I would like to offer, or get more, you know, of my awesome materials, they're much more likely to subscribe. Think of it as a guest leaving your house, and you saying, hey, come back and visit us again. So having that said, let me go on and show you how to use OptinMonster. So I've already gone ahead and installed the OptinMonster plugin on my WordPress website. And now let's go in and create a new opt-in. I'll click on this blue button. OptinMonster comes by default with three opt-in types, and there's more that are going to be coming soon. But since this video is about the Lightbox pop-up, the one that I use in WP Beginner, I'll select that and I'll click on the next step. Then you have to enter the opt-in title. This could be anything that, you know, you want to call it. Test Lightbox 1. This is, you know, only for your knowledge. The next option is opt-in delay, which you can select like 5 seconds, 10 seconds, but that's not what I really like about OptinMonster. What I love is the exit intent technology. What exit intent does, it tracks the user's mouse behavior when they're on your website, and it shows them the Lightbox pop-up only when they're about to leave or when they leave the active window. So when you check this, it overrides the opt-in delay setting. So I'm going to leave opt-in delay setting to zero because it doesn't matter. The next thing you want to make sure you set is the opt-in cookie duration. I'm going to set it at 30, but you know, you want to set it to at least 30. You can go as high as 90 or 365 even. The whole purpose of this is when the user subscribes or if they hit X, you don't want to keep showing them the same offer over and over again. So I'm going to make it 30. The double opt-in feature, I'm going to leave it checked because my email service provider, MailChimp, requires me to, you know, double opt-in everybody. Then the next thing you want to do is select an email service provider. I will select MailChimp. Now, I've already gone ahead and connected my account with OptinMonster. So I'm going to select the list that I have, OptinMonster, and then it's going to say, okay, you know, pick which one of your lists you want. So I'll say the OptinMonster email list. So now basically anybody, this will show you all the segments. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select another list. So basically anybody who subscribed using this opt-in form will be subscribed under OptinMonster exit intent. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click save and design opt-in. I save it, I'll be taken to the themes that I want. So I'll go ahead and pick the case study theme. The bullseye theme allows you to do a lot more customization. So I'm just going to go with, you know, a pre-made theme. There's more themes coming on this as well. So first thing I want to do is I'll add, like, you know, free case study. Actually, let me put the title that I have on WP Beginner. Do you want to learn WordPress? So now, you know, you can go ahead and change the font of it. I like the Brie Serif font a lot in Google Fonts. So I'll select that and I'll even make the font size a little bit bigger. No, that's a little bit too big. Let's make it 36. Okay. So then the next thing I would do is, you know, add a tagline. This could be get free WordPress resources in your email inbox. and you know, you can add whatever you want over there. And then you can select the color of the title. I'm going to leave it as that. Basically, OptinMonster is using the same theme customizer UI that WordPress uses by default. So this is really neat. Now, in the content area right here is only allows for an image, and you can add any image that you like, basically. So I'm going to go and select the image for WP Beginner. Okay, I'll select the WP Beginner image right here. So basically what I've gone ahead and done is I'm going to click on the upload image right here and select my image. Then I have an option to choose show the name field or not. Let's go ahead and show the name field. Say your name, enter your name. And I'll say enter your email. And the next option is to say send me the resources. This is your sign up button. And you know, you can make them bold or whatnot. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change the font color for that and change the font style and make it brie serif. I'm gonna change the font size and make it 20. Then what I wanna do is I wanna change the background color a little bit. So I'll say I wanna go in the green and I want it to be like green. So there you go. Since I have done it already, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit save changes. And this is how my lightbox pop-up is going to look when I put it on the website. I'm going to close out of the design customizer. I'm going to go in the manage output settings. What the manage output setting allows you to do is control where exactly this opt-in should show. The first thing you want to do is enable this opt-in. Now, what this does, it doesn't, you know, now you just enabled opt-in. You haven't selected where you want to show. You can choose to show it globally. That means on every page of the website, whenever the user is going to exit, they will see it. You can also choose to show it on a specific only post, only pages, only on the archive pages, only on a specific category, or even on a specific page just itself. So for the sake of this example, I would load it globally, and then I'm going to hit save opt-in settings. Now, when I click on to view this website, I should be able to, you know, whenever I go on a post or something, and I try to bring my mouse outside of the window, see how it's going to prompt me with a lightbox pop-up. And then now if you enter your name and email here and hit to send me the resources, you just got a new subscriber. So basically, whenever the user is done reading your article and they're about to leave, it's going to prompt them with a lightbox pop-up offer of yours. And guess what? You just got yourself a new subscriber. A lot of popular websites are starting to use these lightbox pop-ups. I've seen it on Cracked. I've seen it on, I believe, Slate and Salon and a bunch of other big-name websites. So this is something that, you know, users are really liking. And the numbers that I have on WP Beginner are just proof of that, you know, users don't mind. Our bounce rate was not affected. We didn't get any complaints. And best of all, you can see that it only took us such a little bit of time to create this.